All right, welcome to Lord Duncan's Rockin' World Food Chat, baby. If you can't tell already, tonight it's a happy Maiden Monday. And because we're doing Iron Maiden tonight, we're going to be making an English dish known as Shepherd's Pie. So, first, what we will do is show you the ingredients. I found a recipe online, it was like 8 ingredients. I'm doing less. I'm gonna make it easier, easy peasy. So, I'm gonna use this size dish. I'm gonna use a pound and a half of hamburger, not quite all this. Half an onion. I'm gonna use some cream styles corn, which was a suggestion to use that instead of beef broth to keep all the beef moist. Then on top of the beef will go peas and carrots, and of course, if you've ever had it before, you then want some mashed potatoes. I'm using Idahoan sour cream and chive, just for a little extra flavor. And for the hell of it, instead of putting cheese on top, I don't think you're supposed to anyway. I'm going to be making just a packet of brown gravy, just to have, you know, maybe throw a little on the side, whatever, or on top, just because I like gravy. So, we got the ingredients shown to you. Which means it's time for step two in honor of Steve Wallace up in Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. And we're hoping to get good news from him soon. He had to head back to Edmonton. Something was going on. We don't know yet. I'm hoping everything's okay. But now it's time for step two, which I have already opened. A little bit, minute ago, I already opened it up. It just happens to be Iron Maiden's Beer Trooper. There you go. It's a little bit heavier than Budweiser, I'll tell you that much. It's not super dark, but it's not, you know, yellow piss beer like a lot of people claim, or swell people claim Budweiser. Like I said, some people at Swill, I think it's Budweiser's swell. But this Iron Maiden beer is also to die for. Absolutely great, absolutely great. Comes in a 4-pack in the cans, about 10 bucks for the 4-pack, but absolutely wonderful. So, just for my friend Jeffrey, I am going to go ahead and do the honor of cutting this up while on camera. Just I know he loves the sound of this knife on this cutting board. But I'm going to go ahead and cut this up before I put it in the meat in there. And then I'm going to do some cuts and pauses on the video there. So you don't have to see me actually cook everything down all the way. But I will say I've got a few of my favorite Iron Maiden records I'm going to talk about, as well as probably a couple of my favorite live shows. The first one I ever saw was back in 1990 for No Prayer for the Dying. So, of course, that album had a special meaning to me, even more than Fear of the Dark. I know, oh, how dare you say that. I think it's better than Fear of the Dark. I just do. I just think the song's better than this. Obviously, Fear of the Dark is great. It's got a couple extras like Afraid to Shoot Strangers, but I think No Prayer for the Dying is freaking awesome all the way through. Mother Russia at the very end. The Assassin. Bring your daughter to the slaughter. Tail Gunner. Shit, it's all great. So I got that going. I'm going to get these onions with the meat in the pan here. I'm also going to go ahead and get these potatoes made up. And I'll be back to you right after that. But first, I'm going to show you basically the first three or four Iron Maiden records you need to buy. And here they are. One moment, please. Okay, here we go. So, you gotta get, I know everyone loves the first two records. I prefer everything with Bruce a bit more, so tough shit. Number of the Beast, first album with Bruce. Second one with Bruce, Peace of Mind. Also where you get the Trooper. Actually, the first one, you know, you get everything like Number of the Beast, Run to the Hills, How It Be Thy Name, Children of the Damned, all that. One of my other top faves, Good Old Power Slave. Tell Me Why I Have to Be a Power Slave. Awesome stuff, dude. And then one of my two favorite live albums, right, of that same tour, Live After Death, the Power Slave tour. They toured for like, I don't know, almost 2 years straight, over a year and a half, live in Long Beach and everywhere else. So, Live After Death. Get these four right away if you have no Iron Maiden whatsoever. Okay, so I got the meat hamburger here, the beef grilling up here with the onion. Just gonna go ahead and get drain that. I already went ahead and did the instant mashed. I'm using instant mashed potatoes just to be lazy. You can do real ones. Do it however you want. And then there's my brown gravy as well, which is just kind of a little extra tidbit there. So back with the air in a flash. Okay, first things first before we go any farther. Daisy, come get your treat, come on. Been a patient little girl, come on. Come get your treat, jump up so you can see on the camera. I don't think I see you or not. Here you go. Good girl, good girl. You have your little treat. All right, now let's add this meat and onion in here. Here we go. Ooh, that's gonna be a lot of meat. If I could just use 1 pound, but what the hell. And yes, I did add lots of pepper to that, and yes, I did drain the grease out of it. Put it over here, get out of the way. Yeah, I think I can use the spatula for the rest of it. All right, so I found a recipe. Let me try this here. We're just gonna try to do some cream corn on top instead of beef broth. Yeah, I'd say, oh hell yeah, definitely the whole can for sure. Rinse that out later, and good old something I got from good old Weird Al Yankovic. If you've ever seen the movie UHF, I got this actually at Spatula City. It's a real place. There you go. Look it up. Spatula City. Weird Al Yankovic. Movie's called UHF. I don't know, 81, 82 probably. Maybe 80, I don't know, somewhere in there. So this cream corn is going to give the meat just a little extra moisture. It'll get some moisture from the onions in there too, but, well, this way we're doing corn, but, I don't know, just a different version of it, I guess. Here you go. Some people can't stand cream corn. I don't mind it. I worked in a corning factory here in Minnesota back in the day, and my job was to, one of my jobs, the best job I had was being the starch guy. I had to fill up this big vat with like 6 50-pound bags of flour, and then add a certain amount of salt, something else, and a bunch of water, and mix it all up. And I would just send it on the line when they were ready to do their cornstarch or doing their cream corn, so it wasn't bad. Shout out to Charlie Brown and family. Anyways, now let's go ahead and get this carrots and peas on top. I'm thinking I don't need quite the whole thing. I need this bad. Let's see how much is left. I'll save that. My old man's coming up here in a couple days. That'll be perfect for his lunch one day. Here we go. All right, now we gotta do the potatoes. Get these all over here. I fear that I may have done two bags of the potatoes possibly. Probably would have been a better idea getting a family size or doing two, but we'll stretch it out and make it work. Oh yeah, it's not gonna be too bad. But yeah, definitely, if you're using this size shape, it's like 9 by 13 kind of oval shaped, probably get the family size potato instead. But this will be right. It's not gonna kill anybody. Oh, there you go, dog.
One little GMC.
That dog will eat anything, man. She likes mashed potatoes. She eats anything.
APR plus 1500 purchase.
All right, so
2024 GMC.
My previous dog did not like anything. Potato at all.
GMC.
And hold on one second here. Gotta turn this shit off. All right, cut. Now cut back. Here we go. Cut. Spread all that around. That top covered. Right now you're listening to Seventh Son of the Seventh Son. Just happens to be my favorite Maiden album of all time. Of all time. Even more than any of the other, even more than Power Slave. Which is obviously a close second. I just love the album all the way through. Like most, like everything else up until it. Here we go. Well, our oven is now set at 400 degrees. Let's put this bitch in there and see how she does, huh? You know what? I'm gonna give it a cover for like the first 20 minutes. I don't want those potatoes to like get browned right away. Cause I want everything to cook for a good 20-25 before it actually starts to brown. And those vegetables are all frozen, so. I guess I should have cooked them up ahead of time. Whatever, woulda, coulda, shoulda. Set this timer real quick. There we go, and I'll be right there in a second. Here, I know my dad said start using my remote control for the camera. I'm a dipshit. Yes, I know. All right. Either way, let's move on. Okay, another couple records you need to hear. One of my favorites, No Prayer for the Dying, 1990. It's the second to last album before Bruce left temporarily. Awesome, awesome, awesome. When Bruce did come back, we had also lost Adrian Smith, replaced by Yannick Gehrs. When Bruce came back, they kept Yannick, so now they got three live lead guitarist just jamming along with Steve Harris and Nick McBrain on drums. Dave Murray and Adrian Smith and Yannick on guitar. Brave New World, like 2000. Awesome, awesome album. Very, very full. They totally evolved into something absolutely ginormous. So check it out. And, of course, Right now, we're hearing a bit of Seventh Son right now. My favorite album of all time by my Maiden. So there you go. Go out and get that one for sure, no matter what. And I will show you my last favorite live record out of the group here very shortly. Well, there we go. Flexi's finally done, babies. Check this shit out, huh? Ooh, baby. I gave it a little broil at the end. Brought up the top a little bit. There you go, as you can see. Woo! She is bubbling, boiling, and cooking away. That's gonna take, 15, 20 minutes to cool off, I think. Before anybody eat it. So, we're gonna just admire this little beauty here. I do say, yeah, you probably wanna go for, if you're doing the potatoes on this size, just get the family size, that'd be perfect. You don't need the double small, just get the, and if you guys have that stuff anywhere else, but I'm thinking you probably do. Well, either way, you'll figure it out yourself, I guess, which is what I'm doing here. But it does look I got at least that much potato at least before it gets. Some vegetables are popped through because I put way too many vegetables in there, but damn vegetables. But so my favorite live record. It's probably Iron Maiden, England, Made in England 88, which is basically the Seventh Son tour live. So it's got all my favorite songs off of that, as well as Somewhere in Time and Good Old Power Slave, and of course all the early ones they had to play back then. So if you get a chance to see Iron Maiden, you really got to do it. It's literally the greatest show on earth, and Bill Bailey, Barman Bailey would be proud to say Iron Maiden is truly the greatest show on earth. You gotta see it. So I actually went for a motorcycle ride today. I tried to make a video, but I had the phone in my pocket like this, but the damn video shot was barely over the dash of my bike, so I have a fairing on there, you know. And, you know, it's tolerable, but it was shaking all around, so I'm just going to wait until I get a GoPro before I actually make you a video from my bike. I have the perfect band's song by my old band, and I'll probably throw in Born to be Wild by The Cult or something like that. But, there you have it. This has got to cool for a minute. I will give you some I'll leave comments on how it turned out, and I'm not sure I'll post a picture of it, but you'll figure it out when you make it yourself. You'll see how it turns out. You know Shepherd Pie, come on. All right, well, Hail Maiden and Up the Irons. Up the Irons, Hail Maiden. And, Keep Calm and Pog Mahone. Keep Calm and Pog Mahone. You bloody wanker. You bloody wankers. All right, peace out. Thanks for watching my show, Lord Duncan's Rock and Roll Food Chat. Please hit the like and subscribe button. Now, if you do hit the subscribe button, you don't have to frickin'. If you get annoyed by all the notifications, you can get rid of the notifications without unsubscribing. Just give me the subscribes, man. I need those so I can start making bank. So I can start giving you guys free t-shirts. Because you know damn well they're going to be the best ones in the world as far as frickin' swag goes. So, all right. You guys rock out. Take care.